One of these young ladies won 3 gold medals in the 1960 Olympic Games. What is your name, please?
My name is Wilma Rudolph. My name is Wilma Rudolph.
My name is Wilma Rudolph.
Only one of these people is the real Wilma Rudolph. The other two are imposters and will try to fool this panel. Don Ameche, Betty White, Johnny Carson, and Kitty Carlisle on To Tell the Truth with your host, Bud Collier.
Thank you very much, and welcome once again to Tell the Truth. Brought to you this week by Anacin, the headache remedy with the combination of ingredients, a special combination to relieve pain, to fight depression, and to calm jittery nerves. Anacin. I'd like to welcome back our good friend, Betty White. Hi, Betty.
Hi, Bud, and it's good to be back.
Well, it's sure nice to have you back. Betty is sitting in for Polly, who is out on the West Coast for a week. I'd also like to welcome another old friend of mine and a very good friend, I hope. A newcomer to our panel, however, but we'll probably be having him back. Johnny Carson. Johnny, how are you?
Thank you. Fine, Dad.
Johnny is sitting in for Tom Foster, on the road with a conquering hero, as you probably know. All right, panel, for the first time tonight, will you open your envelopes and take out your affidavit card and follow along as I read. I, Wilma Rudolph, as a child, was unable to walk. This past summer in Italy, I won 3 Olympic gold medals for running. I am the only American woman in the history of the Olympic Games to be a triple gold medal winner. Signed, Wilma Rudolph. Here you have 3 stalwart young ladies, each of whom claims to be Wilma Rudolph, triple gold star Olympic winner. And let's start this first round of questioning with Don Ameche. Don?
Number one, how many years have you been running?
5 years.
Number two, exactly what was wrong with you as a youngster?
Well, I really don't know. I might have had rheumatism. I don't know.
Did the doctor say anything to you about what was wrong with you, number 3?
No, he didn't.
Number one, what was your time in the 100 meters?
11 seconds.
Number 2, what was your time in the 200?
22.9.
Number 3, who were the other members on your relay team?
Martha Hudson, Barbara Jones, and Lucinda Williams.
Betty?
Thank you, Bud. Number 3, who came in second in the 100 meters?
Dorothy Hammond.
Number 2, where was your home originally?
Clarksville, Tennessee.
And number 1, when did you first start to run?
In high school in Clarksville.
Number 3, how many hours a day do you still run?
2 hours a day.
Number 2, in Clarksville, what is the main street?
There's Kellogg Street.
And there's Johnny Carson.
You know, Bud, this is the story of my life. The last show I guested on was Broadway Open House, and, tonight, I've got to disqualify myself right off. I know one of these young ladies.
You recognize
I know who the young
well,
lady is.
Well, it's too bad to start off that way, but hold your secret. That'll count, of course, as an incorrect vote for the benefit of our challengers. And we proceed to Kitty.
Thank you, Bud. I want to say that I consider this an absolutely miraculous feat. And I'm very proud to know all 3 of you, and particularly the one who is really Wilma Rudolph. I don't know very much about running. I know something about Rome. Where did you stay in Rome, number 1?
At Olympic Village.
Where was that?
That was at where the Olympics were held.
Number 2? I don't know what you're applauding. I just comfort you. Number 2, did you go into Rome at all?
No, I didn't do very much going into Rome at all.
You weren't able to sightsee?
No.
Number 3, where do you run when you run two hours now?
Tennessee University.
You all have marvelous legs. I watched you walking down. Number 1, when you...
Yes, that's it, panel. You've used up all your time, so without any more questions, will you kindly get ready to vote? Without consultation, will you mark your ballots and vote for number 1, number 2, or number 3? And as usual, the team of challengers will receive $250 for every incorrect vote. One of which is already reckoned because Johnny disqualified himself.
Everybody set? Don, for whom did you vote?
I voted for number three, Bud, and I really couldn't tell from the answers because, once again, that Willie has done a fine job of drilling these people. This is pure guess on my part.
Betty, which one did you think is the real one?
Bud, I voted for number three, too, strictly on a hunch because the other two are looking me right straight in the eye and she's kind of a little bit nervous and looking around as if she's really trying not to be who she really is.
Johnny, you disqualified yourself. And Kitty, for whom did you vote?
Well, I voted for number one based on the legs. Number three has rather lovely but sort of slender legs, and number two and number one had sturdier legs, and number one looks like a champion to me.
Okay, there you have it now. We've all cast our ballots, and this is the way our opinions stack up as to which one of these ladies is the triple gold medal winner in the track events of the recent Olympics. So let's find out. Will the real Wilma Rudolph please stand up? Well, our congratulations go along. You know, this late date, and we're mighty proud to have you with us tonight.
But just ensuring I wasn't around.
Johnny had marked the ballot secretly. He just held it up, said number three on it, said, I just want to show you I wasn't wrong. So he was quite right. But, of course, that does act as an incorrect ballot. Let's find out about the other two now. Number one, would you tell us your real name and what you really do?
My name is Julia Robinson, and I'm a social group worker for the New York Housing Authority.
Thank you. And number two, your real name and what you do?
My real name is Fran Bennett, and I'm a telephone operator for Hayes Registry in New York City.
Thank you. Hey, some of you may not know, Hayes Registry is one used by many of the performers in our business, and that's why it's familiar to us. Well, let's check the score now, ladies, and see what we have. We had one actual incorrect vote, and then one disqualified counts as an incorrect vote at $250 each for a total of $500 from Anison, and a gift package of fine products from the makers of Anison for each of you. Thank you very much for sharing your track feats with us. Good night and good luck to you. I would like to state at this time that Wilma Rudolph has appeared with the full consent and permission of the Amateur Athletic Union, and to tell the truth, will donate her share of the prize money to the AAU Olympic Development Fund. Now, panel, let's meet our next team of challengers.
What is your name, please?
My name is Alan B. Christie.
My name is Alan B. Christie.
My name is Alan B. Christie.
Again, follow along, if you will, with your affidavit cards as I read from mine. I, Alan B. Christie, am a barber. In my shop, where we work by appointment only, we not only cut men's hair, but also wave straight hair, straighten wavy hair, do razor cutting, hair coloring, and fit hair pieces. When necessary, we scientifically test our clients' hair for tensile strength and color adaptability. Along with these services, we provide music, extension telephones, and hot coffee. Last month, at the National Barber Show in New York City, I was chosen Barber of the Year. Signed, Alan B. Christie. Panel, you heard as I did, these three gentlemen all claiming to be Alan B. Christie, Barber Extraordinary, and Barber of the Year. Let's start this round of questioning with Johnny Carson. Johnny?
Number one, when one barber cuts another barber's hair, who does the talking?
Usually both of them.
What is the correct name for a toupee? What is it actually called?
Herpes, but there are many names, as you know. One of them is the rug.
No, I didn't know that.
Yes, among barbers, we say the rug.
What's the union price for a haircut in New York City?
I don't know. I'm not from New York.
Number two, what's the union price for a haircut in New York?
I am not from New York City. I don't know.
Number three? No, forget it. How about... how do you straighten wavy hair?
Which number?
Number three. How do you straighten wavy hair?
With permanent wave solution.
Mm-hmm. Number two, how often must you renew your license to be a barber?
Once a year.
In New York?
Kitty?
Number three, what is a mouse? in hair parlance. Number two, what is a mouse?
Never heard of it.
Never heard of it. Number one, there's a famous barber in opera, in an opera. What's his name?
Figaro.
You have an English name here, Alan B. Christie, number one. Are you of English descent?
No, I'm Italian. I'm from Rome.
Uh-huh.
My original name was Alberto Bartolomeo Cristicello. It sounds funny even in Italian.
I see.
Even in Italy.
Number two, can you tell me what a wig is called when each hair is put on separately?
It's, I don't know the process they use, but it's embedded in
Number three,
in
can
silk.
You tell me what it's called when each hair is put on separately?
A hairpiece.
There's another. There's a technical name for the wig.
Oh, that's a wig with hair pieces put on separately. It's a technical.
Number one, number three. What is the best way to tint men's hair?
With a dye.
Which kind of a dye?
A commercial dye.
Okay, Don Ameche, please.
Number two. Why do you use a razor to cut hair?
Usually, the purpose of it is to take away the thickening on the side of the hair if you have an overgrowth on a particular size your razor cut.
Number three, what is the value of a butch haircut?
Well, there is really no value to it. It's a style.
Number one, would you say there's any value to it at all?
Yes, it makes the man very ugly.
On the panel
number two, how long does it take you to give a haircut and a shampoo to a man?
About 20 minutes. A shampoo, haircut 20 minutes, and a shampoo, approximately 45 minutes.
Number three, how long would it take you to give a man a haircut and a shampoo?
About 40 minutes.
Number one, what do you use for dandruff?
Do you need any help?
I don't think so.
Okay. Betty.
Thank you, Bud. Number one, if a Chinese customer came to you for a hairpiece, would you give him an oriental rug?
Oh!
Yeah!
After that one, I'd ask for a flying carpet.
Number two, does tinting tend to make hair more porous or less porous?
More porous.
Number three, would you agree with that?
I would agree.
Number one, would you agree with that?
I do.
Number one, how do you test hair as far as...
There is a special machine which is called testometer. The hair... Did I answer you? Did I hear you correctly?
Yes, I heard it. I think I heard it. I could almost swear. Number two...
They will test hair...
That's it. That's all the time we have. That's it. Just the ones we have. You could call this round, I guess, tinting tonight on the old camp rug. All right. Let's vote now, if you will, please. And in so doing, without consultation, will you mark your ballot and vote for number one, number two, or number three? All set, everyone? Don, for whom did you vote this time?
I voted for number one, Bud. I guess... For several reasons. One, that he seemed to know the most about his business. And number two, I guess it's just maybe in fact, or it's been my experience, that the majority of the barbers I've had in my life have been Italian.
Betty, which one do you think is the real one?
Well, again, I'm voting on hunch, Bud, because number two must have heard what I said about our first contestants, because he stared me right in the eye as he came down the thing. So I think he's trying to fool me. I think it's number two.
Okay. Johnny, for your first vote.
I voted for number one. Because he got more laughs than I did.
Kitty, what about your vote?
Well, I voted for number three. I'm sitting in Polly's seat, so I obviously have caught her disease. I think it's number one. In fact, I'm almost sure it's number one. But the name and the so forth, and I voted for number three. I don't do it as well as she does.
That's the best reason I've heard yet. The maid and the so forth, and you voted for number three. All right, we've got our minds sort of made up. Let's find out who's right and who's wrong. In our own special moment of truth, let's discover which of these gentlemen is the real barber of the year. So, will the real Alan Christie please stand up? Thank you, sir, very much. Very much indeed. Number one, would you tell us your real name and what you really do?
My name is Alberto Traldi. I am a journalist with Il Progresso Italoamericano, and I also teach Italian at CCNY.
Thank you, sir. And I'll bet your class is a ball. Number two, your real name and what you do.
My name is Jack Schott. I represent the Motor Mower Company, and I sell lawnmowers.
Well, there's a similarity between that, barber, and a lawnmower. Okay, let's check on our score now and see what we have. We had only one correct. That leaves three incorrect at $250 each for a total of $750 from Anderson. And again, a gift package of all the fine products from the makers of Anderson. Thank you, gentlemen, very much. You gave us a good time. I hope we gave you one. Good night and good luck to you. Now, panel, let's meet our third team of challengers.
What is your name, please?
My name is Mark Kaminsky. My name is Mark Kaminsky.
My name is Mark Kaminsky.
Once again, panel, will you follow along with your copies of this affidavit? This past summer, I, Mark Kaminsky, an American, toured the Soviet Union with a friend. As we were leaving the country, we were arrested by Russian border authorities. For 9 days, I was grilled by interrogators and finally brought to trial. On September 19th, I was convicted of espionage and sentenced to 7 years at hard labor. Less than 1 month later, I was released from prison and banished from the country. Signed, Mark Kaminsky. Three young gentlemen this time, each claiming to be Mark Kaminsky, who was held prisoner by the Russians. And let's start this round of questioning with Kitty Carlisle. Kitty?
Thank you, Bud. Number one, what was the charge against you?
Espionage.
But for what?
Taking photographs.
Oh. Number two, what is the capital of Siberia?
I don't know.
Number three?
I don't know either.
What is number three? What is Khrushchev's official title?
Premier.
Number one, where did you go? Where is the Ermitage, for instance?
The Ermitage is in the south of Russia.
Number two, where is the Ermitage?
In the south of Russia.
Number three?
It's in the south of Russia.
You never went to Leningrad, any of you? Did you go to Leningrad, number
one? Yes, I did.
You didn't get to... Well, let me see. Number two, who interrogated you?
A military interrogator.
A military interrogator. Were you held in your hotel or were you taken to prison?
At first I was held in my hotel and then subsequently they took me to prison.
Number three, where did you go into the country?
Through Vyborg.
Through where?
Vyborg.
Vyborg. Did you go by plane?
No, by automobile.
Number two, through whom did you get your visa?
Through the United States government, the Russian embassy, and in tourist.
Number three, did you do the same procedure?
Yes.
Number one, where on the border were you stopped?
In Uzhgorod.
Number two, how long did this trial take, the actual trial itself?
It actually took only 1 day.
Number three, what was the name of your attorney?
Kulichenko.
Number one, what was the name of the prosecuting attorney?
Boris Glasnapov.
Oh, I know it.
Number two, what did you have with you when they stopped you?
I had my luggage and a camera, which had some film in it.
Number three, where were you put at hard labor?
I wasn't put at hard labor.
Number one, were you not put at hard labor either?
I was not.
Number two, what were you told when you were released?
I was told that the border was that way. Go home.
Betty?
Thank you, Bud. Number three, why were you released? I mean, I'm glad, but why?
Well, I don't understand exactly why I was released. I appealed, apparently.
Yes, you do. Number one, who is president of Russia?
Luckily, Postolov.
Number two, do you agree with that?
Yes.
Number one, why do you think you were released?
I know why I was released.
Why?
Because my appeal to the Soviet Presidium was successful.
And how did you, number two, how did you make this appeal?
I made it with the defense attorney.
Through your own defense attorney, that is the Russian?
I was given a defense attorney by the military.
Number three, how many men
Johnny?
Number one, what kind of labor were you sentenced to? What was your actual sentence?
My actual sentence was 7 years, not of hard labor. It's, I guess you'd just call it labor.
All righty.
However, this was never served, of course.
Number two, what is the value of a ruble in American current rate of exchange?
Approximately 25 cents.
Number three, what is the current rate of exchange?
It's officially 4-1, I believe.
All right. Well, exactly when were you released, number one?
Released from...
When were you released?
From prison?
Yes.
On the 19th of October.
Number three, you were brought up for espionage?
That's correct.
Were you guilty?
No, I don't know.
Nowadays,
so.
Who knows? Number two...
No.
How long were you in actual detention in Russia?
A little over a month.
Guess that's it. Once again, it's time to vote. And figure out, if you can, which one of these gentlemen is the real one. So will you mark your ballots without consultation and vote for number one, number two, and number three? Everybody set? Okay, Don, which one this time?
I voted for number one, Bud, because with my vast knowledge of the trial proceedings in Russia, you know, and the full court-martial of army and things like that in Russia, I judge his answers were most correct.
Betty, which one did you choose this time?
Well, I was all sold on number one because his answers were so fine until he said the 19th of October, and the affidavit said less than a month later, and that would make it exactly 1 month later. And if I voted for number three, I'd be being sentimental, so I voted for number two.
Johnny, which one do you think is the real one this time?
I voted for number one. He looks like all the spies I've ever known.
And finally, Kitty, which one do you think is it?
Well, I voted for number two. Number one has a Slavic face, like Kaminsky might be the proper name. And number three said that the official title for Khrushchev was premier. I don't honestly think that's his official title. I voted for number two.
Okay, there we have it. And we'll check it up right away as we discover which one of these three gentlemen is the one who was actually held prisoner by the Russians. Will the real Mark Kaminsky please stand up?
Well, cool. Well done, challengers. Well done.
And we're proud to have you with us, too. Believe me, to have had you handle yourself so well. If you hadn't handled yourself well, it's a sin you wouldn't be out of there yet. I don't think it's this much credit to your assigned attorney as it is to your own handling of yourself while you were there. And we're proud of you. Aren't we, panel?
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
Indeed, yes.
We are.
What'd you say, Betty?
I just said yes. You can't get any
sports.
You
can.
Yes, Kitty.
The Ermitage is a famous museum in Leningrad. Did you not go to it?
I didn't go to the Ermitage this year, no.
Oh, because you said it was somewhere in the south of Russia.
I will answer this, and this perhaps may have been misleading. There are Ermitages. There's one in Leningrad, there's one in Moscow, there's one in Kiev.
Oh.
Any answer I would have given would have
been... Well, wonder you got out here shifty.
Yes, Betty.
Thank you.
Question, Mr. Kaminsky, you said this summer. Have you made many trips to Russia?
I was in Russia for the past summer.
The past summer, and had you made trips prior to that?
No.
Next time, don't take
your
camera.
What do you have in your camera?
Film.
Well,
all right, that's all we have time for.
Number three.
Number one, would you tell us your real name and what you really do, please?
Mark Scherer. I'm an attorney in New York City.
Would have been interesting for you to have tried a case like that, I'm sure. Number two, your real name and what you do.
My name is Mel Poritz. I'm the advertising manager for the Topps Bazooka Bubblegum Company.
He would have chewed his way out of Russia. Well, gentlemen, checking the score, we find a clean sweep for you and a clean loss for the panel this time. That means four incorrect at $250 each for a total from Anderson of $1,000. And well worth eating at a table, I would agree. And of course, on the way out, a gift package of fine products from the makers of Anderson. Good night to you, gentlemen. God bless you. Good times always come to an end too quickly. It was nice having you, Betty, and you, Johnny, here with us tonight. And all I have left to say to you is good night, panel.
Good night,
Bud.
And bless you. Bud Collier saying good night from Anderson and reminding you to tell the truth. Good night, everybody.
has been brought to you tonight by Sleepy's, the non-narcotic sleeping tablet. Sleepy's for a good night's sleep. Johnny Olson saying goodnight from To Tell the Truth. The preceding program was pre-recorded.